What it is though, it is cuisine and things, and today we will be making banana pudding cheesecake. Alright, let's get this thing shapoppin'. We're gonna start off with just regular Jell-O brand mix. I have two different flavors here. I have French vanilla flavor and I have banana flavor. Keep in mind that all of the ingredients will be down in the description, but I want you guys to know that I was making enough pudding mix for two cheesecakes. So if it looks like a lot of pudding, a lot of vanilla, a lot of sugar, I was making a mix for two cheesecakes. Alright, so I added 1 cup of milk to both of these mixes. I was trying to make my cheesecake a little more stiff, but if you want it to be more consistent of banana pudding, go ahead and do the 2 cups of milk like the box recommends. Sit this in the refrigerator for about 3 minutes. Alright. Alright, so now we have our cream cheese. Now, normally what you should do is let this sit out for I don't know how long in order to get it to room temperature. You want it not to be cold, but as you can see, I was being fast and I started mixing this and it was sticking to the blades. That is not what you want. You want it to be softened, as they say. So after that struggle was completed, I went ahead and started adding my sugar. Look at that thing. Sprinkle that thing on in. I added my sugar to this. Remember, I am adding double the amount because I'm making two cheesecakes. Don't you add all that sugar to your one cheesecake because it's going to be diabetic sweet. Now it's time to make this thing thicker than a snicker. So I'm adding my heavy whipping cream right there. And then we're also going to take our vanilla extract and add it right now, right before we start mixing it for a second time. Now the second time that you're mixing is the time where you're going to get it to the right consistency to your liking. Now I wanted mine to be a little more stiff, so I blended it or hand mixed it a little longer than you probably would, but that's just my preference. So you want to make sure you're twisting your bowl, spinning your bowl around, making sure you're getting every inch of that batter. You want to make it as smooth as possible without over mixing. Look at that. I took the spatula and went around the bowl. That thing is thick. That thing thicker than the cafeteria lady arms that make the good pizza. It's time to mix in your banana and French vanilla flavored pudding. Now remember, I'm using two different flavors. You can use half and half to make one box, or you can use just one flavor if you want, but I just think this combination is so lit, and I'm going to give credit where credit is due because someone put me up on this game right here. She always makes banana pudding and I say, what did you do? And she mixes these two flavors right there, so I'm going to give her the credit that she deserves. You deserve it. You deserve that. All right, we're gonna fold in, not mix. You're gonna kind of fold in this. You don't wanna over mix. The batter is already beat. It's beat to the gods. Don't beat it anymore. Fold it in. It's gonna take some time, but fold it and fold it. At this point, your batter is complete. It should be as thick or as thin as you would like it to be. This is a store-bought crust, so what I did was put egg wash on it and baked it for about 5 minutes because I noticed that the store-bought crust normally breaks apart when you try to cut it. So with that method being done, after you cut into it, it actually holds together very well. So I filled the pie crust about halfway. I made it very even. You know, presentation is half the battle. If it looks good, you eat it. And you go ahead and start adding your vanilla wafers. Don't get the off-brand stuff. If you get the off-brand stuff, it's not gonna taste right. People gonna eat it, they're gonna take one bite and they gonna throw it straight in the garbage. Okay, so I have a banana here. This banana isn't overripe because I don't want the bananas to turn brown within 1 day of me making this cheesecake. So this is just a regular sweet banana that has just a couple of spots on it, and I cut it into nice chunks because it's crazy to me that some people don't want to taste the banana inside of banana pudding. That's just weird to me. I want to taste the banana. All right. Here's a little tip. Go ahead and add another layer of vanilla wafers. That right there gives it that good crunch. You already have the crust at the bottom. Then you have a layer of cheesecake. Then you have this good thick layer of vanilla wafers and bananas. And right back on top, another layer of cheesecake. That right there is lit to the max. After you finish layering your vanilla wafers and your bananas, you can add some more of that banana pudding cheesecake mix to the top and begin to spread it and get it nice and even. If you added the 2 cups of milk to your banana pudding mix, then this part would be way easier because the batter will pour easier over the whole top. But I had to put in a little bit more elbow grease to make this thing work. So after this, we're going to begin to put our finishing touches on this banana pudding cheesecake. And as you can see, it's just some crunched up vanilla wafers. I didn't go fancy with this. I took it in my hand, I crunched it up, I spread it around, I made it look nice and appetizing. Remember, half the battle is how it looked. If it looks good, then I might consider eating it. But there you have it. This has been another tutorial. I'm going to have more videos just like this. Go ahead and like this video, comment on this video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you in the next one. Deuces.